A groundbreaking dance track next. Lay All Your Love on Me was the first ABBA song to be released exclusively on a 12-inch single. It was also the first not to have its own specially shot video. Instead, the band edited together a mixture of old ones in a way that was state-of-the-art. Well, in 1981 at any rate. But its chorus relied on the most tried and tested weapon in the ABBA armory, the unique blend of Agnetha and Frida's voices singing together.
It was actually the tone of the voices that worked so well together. A certain, like, brightness to the ear was like sunshine.
To blend, to sound like one person, that takes you have being around that person all the time and knowing when they're gonna breathe. All that is so important.
The blend of our voices was something very special.
I can hear it miles away. Mm. You know, when I hear it somewhere being played in a in a department store or something from way back, that's us.
At 13 in our search for the nation's favourite ABBA song, you voted for one of their gentler hits.
I had a dream, a song to sing, to help me cope with anything.
I don't know when it was, but you had this big party in your house at Limio. We had written I Have a Dream. We had also recorded a backing track, and I was at home writing lyrics. I was supposed to be at that party. Anyway, I had written half of it, and I called Benny to check it with him.
I believe in angels, something good in everything I see.
And he said, wonderful, come over, we must sing it.
Now I remember.
Yes.
And with all the guests, we were surrounded.
Yes.
We surrounded the grand piano.
The grand piano.
Exactly. And Benny played and we all sang along. Yes, yes, exactly.
And again and again and again.
It's the only ABBA song to feature other singers in the form of a children's choir. And the moment when a different locally recruited group of kids joined the band on stage each night became a highlight of the live show.
What happens is this, the two girls will go out there, you'll all be there, and the two girls will go out and get you, and you come in and you stand in these positions. Exactly.
We had a bit of work to do with them before. They actually felt very comfortable with it.
Yes, and I think I was the one who usually
rehearsed. You were the one, yes, absolutely.
With the kids. Mm.
And it's not good if one of you is too close, you know, because then they'll overhear you. So as close as you can, but all of you.
The key was quite difficult for them. Children mainly need a high kind of key. As I was the lead vocal in that song, it was a low key.
They have to sing very deep down, you know.
But as the young hopefuls took to the stage each night, there wasn't a dry eye in the house. Looks like there was the odd runny nose too.
Kids choir, great song. Then the song appeals to everybody. All the ABBA songs have mass appeal. They can appeal to little kids, mammies, daddies, everybody. All the family can sing to ABBA.
Still to come on the nation's favourite ABBA song, there's dancing on the tables.
I've never been so terrified.
What happened when Madonna wanted to sample ABBA?
Normally we would say, write your own songs.
And the ABBA song that has an extraordinary effect on Chris Tarrant.
Gimme, gimme, gimme a man after midnight.
Welcome back as we continue our countdown of ABBA's greatest musical moments. As a band, they've been outsold only by the Beatles, and their sophisticated songwriting is second to none.
If you change your mind,
take a chance,
I'm the first
take a chance, take a chance, take a chance, take a chance, take a chance,
take a chance.
This is an act whose songs are so infectious that even the backing vocals are irresistible.
Take a chance, take a chance, take a chance.
And especially so in the 1978 sing-along classic that gave ABBA their seventh UK number one.
Take a chance.
Wow!
I remember the story. One of your jogging rounds, you got the rhythm.
Yes.
And
take a chance came up. So what are the words you can fit into that percussive sound? Take a chance. So go running. The lyrics is go running.
I quite find it quite a cheeky song, but it is that thing of like when you really like someone and you're like, just give it a shot. You've got nothing to lose, you know, and it might be brilliant.
Take a Chance on Me was to gain a new lease of life as a show-stopping moment in the Mamma Mia stage show. And who can forget Julie Walters in the movie?
Feeling down. Speech!
She made it very much her own, the wonderful scene where she gets up on the table and just strides down the table singing the song is very much her improvising.
If you're all alone, when the pretty birds have...
I've never been so terrified. There's Pierce and Stellan and Meryl. So I just thought, I'm just going to do it as if I'm absolutely drunk.
Do the test, let me try.
And I'm just going to be completely gross.
Take a chance on me.
Next, a song with a killer keyboard riff that started life with the title Been and Gone and Done It, but reached number three in 1979 as Gimme Gimme Gimme.
Gimme 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 is a song for all the ladies. Like, the girls just love it.
It was sexy, it was naughty, and it was just about sex.
It's the kind of raunchy number that can whip even the most unlikely listener into a frenzy.
I remember when ABBA first came to the UK, we went to see them in a big theatre in Birmingham, and I had a huge big boss then, big guy called Terry. Two of us are standing on our chairs going, gimme, gimme, gimme a man after midnight.
Everybody loved ABBA.
Keyboard riff is so recognisable. Madonna obviously used it as well, which made it even more iconic than it already was.
Yep, Madonna sampled the song in her 2005 global chart topper, Hung Up. But getting ABBA's permission to use it was no gimme.
Normally people approach us with a request to use parts of songs, we would say. Write your own songs.
Instead of asking for permission, she recorded the finished track, and only then did she ask Björn and Benny for permission to use the sample.
Benny and I listened to it. It just took half a minute for me, probably the same for Benny, to realize how great that was.
The fact that they agreed to it is, I mean, kudos on them, because I think Hung Up is a fantastic song. It's one of my favorite Madonna songs. It's one of my favorite pop songs from the last 10 years.